Hello, everybody. Thank you for joining me. This is GGF, bringing you episode 9 of Let's Try Objects in Space by Flat Earth Games and 505 Games Publisher. We are doing the dang thing in this game. Really enjoying it. Hope you guys are too, if you've been watching the LT. If not, feel free to go back and check out some of the earlier episodes. It's a lot of fun. Okay, we're on Sterling. I don't remember what we were doing here, though. Oh, they had cheap artworks. Yes, buy those, son. Oh, they got a lot of cheap stuff, but I can't really afford it. I have 383. Maybe I should take out a little bit of a loan to pick up like some of this. Yeah, I'm gonna bus out. They're offering me more of a loan, I think. Offered 998 at 2%. Which ones are the ones I have? The green? No, the purple are the ones I still owe. I only owe what? 3,000. That's not bad. So I should take out. Probably $1,000. I'll take that. And I'll buy some stuff with it. We'll try some other stuff like maybe the industrial. 8 for 200. 30C for the industry. You know what? Let's come back to Commerce Link. Current passenger special, not booked through auto travel, huh? Oh, we can take stuff to Leo. Oh my gosh, they got a lot of stuff in Maru, in Leo. We're going to Maru anyway. 78 units, dang. 18 radioactive waste. In Kansa, no. Computers to LaGrange, no. Prefect in Leo. 17 electronics for 320. I'd be better off. Oh, 18 hours time limit. That's not good. I'd be better off just buying the electronics myself and taking them to Leo. 973. Let's go to right here. Grab another pod. Just to have. 250 to shield it or temperature control. What do we have here? Above market. Below market for medical supplies. We need shielded. Or 14 times 2 would be 280, shielded 250 for explosives. Let's get a pod number, I don't know, 6 and shield it. Why not? Now let's go to here and see if we can. Oh, we can. They're only 20 apiece for the explosives. I'm gonna grab them. 280. We're down to 343. I'm gonna go with this run and hope we make a bunch of money. I have a good feeling about it. Ship's bought and sold. That's it for here. Can I talk to you? Can't take contraband with homie on board, so don't even try. 40C to pay. We're gonna pay the fees. We're gonna request permission. We're in Tiga. We have a lot going on that's kind of time sensitive though, so we've got to be a little quick about things. Everything's good. We have no new messages. But we have a lot of cargo. I do not want to lose this to a pirate. We have to go through the Maru, and that's going to be quite a jump. That's way up here, man. Let's go. I'm gonna turn the music on, guys. Even though it makes my videos get a copyright thing. Not that I get in trouble or anything, but they just disable my monetization, I think. Is what happens, but oh well. Let's go, guys. Tomorrow. There's a lot going on in Maru. Hopefully we get that original contract tomorrow in time. Tomorrow. Today to tomorrow. Tomorrow. Today go to tomorrow. Alright. Hopefully we don't get jumped on the way. I could put in a false police report saying there's someone in Quadrant A out to get me. Send them up here early. There goes Nimble. Wish he would escort me. That's a long way to go. In the fog of war here. Hopefully no asteroids. Got a lot of good goods. I think we can make quite a bit of money off of them. Those cheap artworks in this system, in the Tega system. Tega is financially pretty hurt though, so that's why everything is cheap here. I think we read that in the news, but here we go, guys. Oh, let's Encon it. Or is it too early to jump into that? Well, we can go a little bit. So far, no unknowns are spotted. Let's save the MCON for when we get a little further up here. So far, so good. Oh no, the burners. Bruh. Stop with the burners. Stop the burn. Dang it, look what you did. Stop the burn. Stop the burn. Man. Just go. We're in MCON. Oh my gosh. Why are we burning so much? No idea why. Is that nebulae? If we can make it to there, we're pretty safe. I mean, why is this such a burn? Can anybody explain to me why we're burning here? Is this a glitch with the autopilot or something? Is it because it's just a glitchy autopilot? Thrust vector. Orientation and thrust vector, I don't know. I have no idea why the burn is going like this. Makes no sense, does it? No clue. And it's still burning. Why? Excuse me, but do you have coffee back here? Yeah, there's a pot just outside your cabin in the corridor. I see, thank you. So how's it all going back there? I see you're chatty again. Very well, if we must talk, what will it be today? What would you like to talk about? If that is a joke, you should know that a man my age has very little sense of humor. We could pick up where we left off, I guess. Well, my name's Artem, and I was a professor at the University on LaGrange. Tell me what more you must know, and perhaps we can make this a quick one. What did you teach? Astronomy, the observance and study of celestial objects, the motions of the heavens. I headed the department at Meyer University since planetfall. That sounds like an important job. I ran the faculty at Kyiv Polytechnic at age 20. I taught and studied with Vandervat and Antonova aboard the Cassandra. It was Meyer University. Oh man. Sorry about that, bruh. I hope we can still talk. I hope we can still talk. That was interesting. Let's pay the fee. It's only 35. Let's jump. And, meanwhile... No, it's gonna cut off our jump, isn't it? Is it here? In Maru. Okay, we're in Maru. We have to go. We have 16 hours left. We have to go to Angoda. So come up here. Angoda. Boom, it's right there. Dang. Error, no comms module. Is the comms module out? No. Comms module's fine. Oh, there it goes. Well, I lost my conversation with Artem. Maybe I can go back and talk to him this way. There he is in there, that's awesome. Dang, I wanted to talk to him. That's kind of a bummer because we should be able to reconnect that conversation. Now I lost out on that. Yeah. Oh well, I guess. Comms are back up, can I? Huh. Oh. Why is zero blinking there? Huh. I don't understand any of this. Orientation, we're going that way. Thrust vector, why is that that way? I don't know, we autopilot it all the time. AP. I don't know. But we about to make some money, son. Hopefully Angoda buys these artworks and stuff. That'd be sweet. Should be a pretty safe journey now. Just in case, I think we'll... We'll cruise. Getting good mileage out of MCON right now. Who's that up there? Reyna spots us. Okay, we're close enough to Angoda. Now, is it turning the thrust vector? No, it's turning that. The burn. That must be the burn. Or the thrust vector. I don't know what this blue line is. Oh. I don't know. Something to do with autopilot. But we about to make some credits, son. 5 new news. Let's go. What is that? Okay, artworks. 285, they're way below value. Industrials below value, electronics below value, explosives below value, but we have a contract to deliver. I think it's this. No, it is this. 300 credits. 36 ceramics to Magella. 10 hours limit. Oh boy. Difficulty hard. Can we pick up some goods below market? 7 for 70 of helium 3. 8 for 80. Oxygen. Scrap. I think we'll pass on that. Oh, they're undamaged. Do we have any damaged ones? No. What did I need to get? A ship one. And a row alt. That's a little expensive. Sal saw or an octan. Probably go with an octan. Everything giving emissions here. Okay, we're in Ngota. What did I want to do while we were here? There was something else. Take Artem to Diwali, Galileo. That's it. We have to go to Diwali. Probably have to go up there to Magella. Stop at Phil Station. Or Cox's Bazaar, maybe. And then Phil Station to try to sell these goods. Although they're probably cluster-wide prices. We'll grab one Octan Ship 1. SHP 1 for 50. Contracts we don't want to do. Oh, wait. It goes to Magella. 10 hours. United Leon Space Enterprises. Difficulty hard, though. 10 hours is not enough. I don't know. I like the money. Well, let's check our PDA. See if we can make this trip. We have to go all the way up here. Then we go to Magella, and from here, can we zoom out? Oh, we don't have any data for Magella. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna, I don't know. Should I do it, guys? I think we should just head to Diwali. Maybe. I don't want to lose their credits forever. It's hard, so that's why I don't want to take it. And how much are we paying here? 60? Let's get out of here. Let's make something more efficient, like, let's see. Emissions 13. Emissions 3. Emissions 10. Let's work on the sensors a little bit. Think we could put a ship one in here for the connects. There's the connects. Yeah, the Octan really is an improvement over that. Big time. And we have an Octan, okay. The Elander is beautiful. We got good parts in here. Octane emission relay, we could put a short buffer. Lower the emissions a little bit, I guess. Download now. Got some mail. Email received. Oh. Thank you for your recent completion of a contract. Delete it. Let's go. Before we go, though, we'll sit here for a second. We'll check out Cox's Bazaar. Let's hail them. And see their buy prices. Artwork is below. Yeah, everything else is below. Yeah. Goods for sale. Scrap. Leo and Tega. Explosives. We're not going to Leo right now, though. We are headed to Magella Jump Gate. Or no, let's hail, even though it's going to be the same story, I think. The fill station. This whole system is... it's not good. Yeah, everything's below. Same prices. Same prices. Samarium goes for good price. Water. Ah, I didn't mean to click that, sorry. About to be scanned. Goods for sale. Bionics. Industrial machinery. Good prices on... they'll give us 5 credits to take the radioactive waste, but what do we do with the radioactive waste? Medicines. I can't tell if some of those are green and some are yellow. I'm colorblind in that way. Like, it looks like the 25 is green, but this is yellow. I don't know. We're gonna head there, though, and see what we can pick up. Let's go. Through the nebula. We're gonna head toward Diwali. Get Artem taken care of. Try to get some news in while we can. Attempt made on Governor Proud's life. Life of Daros Governor Derek Proud by Stephanie Beatrice. Originally published by the Magellan Courier October 6th. A shocking news story is emerging today as Magellan security forces on Daros were forced to cancel proceedings of a speech to be given by Canson Governor Derek Proud after an attack on his life was revealed. The governor was to give a speech at Civic Square on Davros to address people directly concerning housing problems, but Canson terrorists had other ideas. Magellan security forces quickly returned Proud to his ship after discovering the plot at the very last second. After confirming the information from confidential informants that as many as 3 shooters were poised to attack from the gathered crowd, at least 2 reports of concealed firearms having been spotted by Magellan security have been confirmed, but neither suspect was apprehended, and both are still at large, presumably on Daros itself. The precise reason for the attack is still unclear, and we'll follow this story as it develops further. We're in Big Nebulae. But no asteroids, so we Gucci. Let's see. Let's get more news in. We're safe. Part 2, the boat. We'll come back to that. Review communal child rearing, a history. How does Lisa McKelley's new book stack up by Samuel Talisi? Published October 6th, The Penitent Times. Lisa McKelley's new book, Communal Child Rearing, A History, follows on from her best-selling analysis of the Sagan's Lights Project and takes her brazen, brash style of no stone unturned investigation and points it squarely at the communal creches, which have dominated child rearing thought for over a century now. Until the end of the 21st century, she writes, schooling away from one's parents was the domain of boarding schools, known for their strictness and isolating effect. It was a fortuitous blend of the more successful elements of boarding schools and a newfound shared responsibility among communities for all children, which collided to make the communal creche program happen. Her book explores the evolution of the communal creches from boarding schools to community hubs and finally into entire districts dedicated to the shared growth of and instruction for children and adolescents. McKelley also points to the freedom enjoyed by parents who are no longer forced to attach so directly to their children, but notes that this is offset by the deep bigotry aimed at parents who still choose to raise their own. In the overall, children raised in creches are far more likely to be successful in life, so there's little chance of Apollo turning back at this point. Oh, we deep in this nebula. We're almost there, too. What is that? Cargo. Let's head there. Maybe we can do something with it. Looks like we're safe up until then. Svobodra, Devil in the Shadows by Tammy Watson, published by the Parsusian. October 6th. Hero to some, villains to others, the Svobodra organization has long been a controversial topic amongst the people of Onega, but what do we really know about this group spoken about in hushed whispers? Svobodra, from the local miners' cross-culture slang, loosely meaning free, but more properly to mean without rule or free form, or free from, which some trace back to the food shortages of the Parsusian Revolution of 19A, but truly showed its face and force in earnest during the 23rd unrest, when the Onega troubles reached a violent tipping point, culminating in civil destruction and rioting. Rumors have long circulated about Svobodra's involvement in the troubles, never seeming to be directly involved in political violence of the time, but always being a definite presence throughout. Some say they sourced weapons and ran transportation and protection for people heavily involved in the uprising. Others say they were smuggling food across blockages to feed families caught in the crossfire of this political struggle. One thing is for certain, in the following years, Svobodra amassed a strong yet moderate small network throughout Onega and in a smaller part of the rest of the Parsus sector. I want to check something. Okay, we're still going. Too bad it doesn't keep it up, though. That's what's not good. Smaller part, the rest of the Parsus sector by building on the Parsus, by building on the network's contact and in some ways power made during their involvement with 23A unrest. In 42A, the best-selling The Fall of the Union by John, which charted the rise and fall of Aromi. Ooh, we're moored to the cargo pods. We'll have to read this later. We are moored to the cargo pods. Can I? Look at this. 20 erbium. We'll take it. How do I transfer it? Empty pod. Empty pod temp. Standard. Transfer pod. We can't do it. Pod standard. No cargo pod? Do we take the whole pod? Why can't we take it? erbium. Does it have? It's not. Doesn't have to be shielded. Pod standard. Contains nil. Max 20. 20. Do I press the number 1? What are we doing wrong here? What am I doing wrong? Does something need to be connected? That's a module. We do this. Isn't this gonna blow if we do this? The external pressure is 0. Huh. We're moored here. Why can't we do anything with it? Cargo pods. Reg 1001. Burn, rotate. Did that do it? Now, can we transfer them? I don't know, man, it's not letting us. That's weird. We clearly have room in this pod. We can't even transfer to that pod for some reason. Deactivate IFF. Those are weapons. Cargo. You can jettison one of them. Grappling arm module. We don't have a grappling arm module. Dang, we need a grappling arm. Wow. Dang, okay, let's go to fill station. Need the grappling arm. But, anyway, while that's going, Svobodra, who knows what they are. The best-selling Fall of the Union by John John, which charted the rise and fall of Aromi Sinha's political influence over Salo and Onega. Many accusations of criminal activities were leveled at Svobodra and its supporters, John claims these criminal activities center on Onega but subtly run all the way through the Parsis sector and through all levels of commerce and society, and their involvement includes low-level protection rackets and work pass forgeries all the way to importation and exportation of illicit substances and restricted ordnance. Later in the work, he goes on to describe them as, if not in league with the Morris Syndicate, at least a backdoor associate. But in the AO mess hall in Central Ruza, they speak of them in a different manner. They are our friends and comrades, one enthusiastic local said to us. Always ready to help out a widow, an older lady chimed in. From what we could find, the conversations surrounding Svoboda were generally positive, and at worst dismissive of their ability to make local political change. This is due to the fact that the public face of Svoboda has a concerted move towards political legitimacy, running for public office under a campaign describing their charitable works and support for the miners, with a platform of increasingly aged workers, housing, continuing improvements in safety regulations, and expanding existing medical care services to the injured and families of workers. All the while, rumors of standover tactics, bribery, and violence continue to grow. Gee, I wonder why, right? Can we go there, please? I gotta manually control it, don't I? Wait. Oh, jeez, I'm totally busting this up. We're gonna run out of juice. Should be good now. Do the old trick this way that we learned from the autopilot. Get there? Dang, I messed it up. I'm learning though, a little bit. Doing? Oh my gosh. This other ship's messing me up. Oh, here we go. We got this now. Look how fast we're coming in, though. Could hit full stop. There we go. Getting the hang of it a little bit, but we need to do those grappling arms. Two new news. Let's come here. Welcome to Fill Station. Oh, it is gonna cost me extra docking fees, but 60. We sell the artwork? Below. At market average for bionics. Below for medicines. 5 for 100. Below for machinery. Below for industrial. Below for medical supplies. It takes shielded though. Same with, they'll give us 5 credits per the radioactive waste. These require temp. We have that. We'll buy them. Okay. Any contracts for us? Ooh. Where are we headed next, actually? To Magella. Not enough space, not enough space. Cox's Bazaar. Man, there's a lot of... What's the Leo Sagan's lights? Look at that. 52 industrial, 529 on delivery. Tega. That's a couple jumps. Oh, 8 hours. That's impossible. Or at least hard. Logo and Leo. Cox's Bazaar, not enough space. That's easy, but not really worth it. Can't take a passenger, right? Nothing else to really look at then. Let's undock. Hopefully we have enough money to get through here. We bought medicine, so that's probably worth it. We have to head to here. Jump to Magella. What are we doing in Magella? Heading to Diwali. What can you do with the jump gate? Oh, no communication available. I need a grappling arm module. It's a module. It's probably thousands of credits. And I have to see how long we've been playing this episode. I tend to rock these for an hour. 42 minutes. Yeah, we'll stop once we get to the gate here. We'll head to Diwali, take Artem up there, get 2600. Listen to cool music that gets me copyright. Copyrighted. Copyright hit. Looks pretty safe. Workers protest for their rights. Brief protests took place on Roger Davies yesterday by Antonio Moroni, October 6th at Tegan Mir. It's a cold, dark day outside. Dust flies past Sterling Industrial in record gale force winds, which, while violent, can't be heard from within the massive manufacturing complex where security forces face off against disgruntled workers. Chants of workers first, safety first, and fair work for fair workers can be heard echoing throughout the dank halls of the grubby facility as hundreds of workers march on Sterling Central Office to demand a litany of changes. This was a scene which took place yesterday. Today, these same halls are quiet. While absenteeism is still high, many people are back to work. As yet, we have no knowledge of what, if anything, Sterling Industrial CEO Fuang Cao has promised the workers, but for now at least, things seem to have abated. Sterling Industrial has recently been embattled with the Tegan Commonwealth in a number of charges of neglect and safety concerns for workers. A court date for initial investigations is yet to be set by the Tegan High Court. Alright, we Gucci. So I want to thank you guys for joining me. Hope you enjoyed this episode as we make our way towards Diwali. Stay tuned for the next one. We're going to continue having fun. And, heading that direction. So I hope you'll stick with me. And I'll see you then. Hope you're enjoying as well. If you're sticking with me, then you must enjoy it, right? Hope so. Take care, guys. Last save was aboard Maru Magella Jump Gate. Awesome. technically we can get out of here right now. We don't have to wait for the bell. But thank you guys, you are awesome. Much love, peace, and joy. Be well, and see you in the next one. Bye-bye.